When designing your garden, we would always suggest you keep in mind the things you like doing best, such as sitting and reading, entertaining friends and family, or keeping a small child busy. This doesn't mean that has to be the sole focus, but it is helpful to decide what the majority of your space should be allocated to. Hello! So this video kind of follows on from previous videos about doing the gravel and the patio. However, it gives more of an overview of the garden as a whole. Now, it was about a year ago that we actually started our garden makeover, and to be honest, there are still a few bits and pieces that need finishing, some things that need planting, but we're not natural gardeners, and the call of the pub is quite strong sometimes. Anyway, as I mentioned, I'm not a garden designer, and if you have a large or overly complicated design in mind, then we would always suggest hiring a professional. This video is more geared towards the lower maintenance, lower budget DIY garden makeover, obviously with a leaning towards using gravel and other hard landscaping, as that is where my knowledge lies. We moved into our house about 7 years ago, and the garden was the worst thing about it. There were a lot of uneven, ugly concrete paving slabs, and pea gravel that had seen better days. The only thing we actually liked about the garden were the bushes, which we have kept. We have wanted to sort out the garden for a long time. However, it was only last year that we finally managed to get around to doing it. Although, because our garden renovation was such a long time in the making, it did give us a good chance to observe it all year round, which is helpful as it will look very different in the winter. However, there are useful apps you can use to track the sun path throughout the year. The first thing we suggest doing is setting a budget. You need to have at least a rough idea of how much you are willing to spend. It may be that you can't afford to do everything straight away, in which case you could prioritise changing the areas that you think will be used the most, or perhaps the area that looks the worst. You may already have a good idea of how you want your garden to look, but if you need some inspiration, we found online sites like Pinterest, Instagram and Houzz a great source. There are also countless garden magazines chock full of great garden design ideas. We found sketching the garden really helpful and would always recommend doing this. It doesn't need to look great, my drawing skills are about on par with our 3-year-olds, but the aim of the sketch is to mark out the areas where you plan to have the different elements. You then need to measure each area so you can get a good idea of the quantities you require of any hard landscaping materials or plants. And you can also check how much space you will have for things like furniture. Also, make a note of anything you want to keep, such as trees or features. Mark the areas which receive a good amount of sunlight, as if you are planning something like a vegetable patch or seating area, this will be the better location. You will also need to note any manhole covers or where the drains are, as rainwater will need to run off in the direction of the drain. Ensure you mark any low areas that might flood. You can then start to consider solutions to problems, such as turning an area that floods into a pond, or choosing light-coloured stones to brighten dark and shady spots in your garden. As our garden is very low at the front, we decided to keep the existing raised beds. However, we replaced the old rockery stone and bricks with new wooden sleepers, which we coated in a waterproofing varnish. We learnt the hard way to also ensure you know if there are areas of your garden that birds perch. We didn't realise that our TV aerial is a favourite resting spot to our local bird population. Needless to say, the droppings have stained both our paving and our gravel. The aerial also makes a small section of our garden wetter than the rest of it, and the result is the gravel below has started to go a bit green. Therefore, we would always recommend you do a thorough site survey of your garden and look up as well as down. Paving and decorative stone are both great low-maintenance, hard landscaping solutions and are available in such a huge range of colour options that you will find something to suit any garden design. Hopefully you have a colour scheme in mind, though this may have to be based around what will be most suited to your space and surrounding areas. For instance, darker materials will be better for areas that get walked over a lot with muddy boots, and white stones may discolour more quickly in wet areas. Our colour scheme was based around my love of the polarised gravel. Therefore, other elements in our garden have been chosen to complement it. A couple of things to note if you are using gravel. Hard-wearing chippings such as basalt, granite, flint or quartz are more suitable for use in areas that will be driven over, or that receive high volumes of foot traffic. These products also take longer to discolour, so are better for use in damper areas too. We chose Polar Ice Gravel, which is a marble product and a semi-soft material. This means it is harder wearing than limestone or sandstone, but not as hard wearing as granite, basalt, flint or quartz. And although it is faring well in most areas of our garden, algae has started to discolour it slightly in the damper areas. Our paving is concrete, and we did find it went a little green over the winter, although the green does come off fairly easily with soapy water, a brush and some elbow grease. However, if you want paving that won't discolour and is very low maintenance, we do suggest you use porcelain. We wanted to replace our old patio with a new one, so that we had a flat, solid area for our daughter to play, and we did hire landscapers to install it, as we weren't at all confident in our abilities to do so. We have created a separate video on how to install a patio. We did lay the gravel ourselves, but that was a much easier job. You can also enhance gravelled areas with other decorative aggregates, such as pebbles, cobbles or boulders, to add height and interest to your space and bring a more natural feel to your garden. Once you have settled on a design and chosen your colour scheme, it is time to source your products. If you are using a landscaper, you could speak to them as they may have a preferred supplier. However, the internet is always a fantastic medium for finding the products that you want. If you are ordering online and samples are available, then we do recommend ordering one, just to check it will be right for your space. If you're planning to grow plants in your garden, then we suggest you check the type of soil you have, as some plants survive better than others in different earth types. However, if your soil isn't suited to what you want to grow, there is always the option of creating raised beds or using pots and tubs filled with topsoil and compost. We decided against creating borders with plants or flowers due to space. However, we are big fans of organic fruit and veg, so have chosen to grow a selection of our own fruit and vegetables in the front bed that receives the most sunlight. We did have to remove quite a bit of the old soil, as it had a lot of clay in it, and have replaced it with a mix of topsoil and compost. We also want to encourage bees into the garden, so we relocated our lavender and fuchsia bushes into the other front bed, which luckily do seem to have mostly come back to life. We also planted a selection of bedding plants. Some have survived and some haven't. We generally found the smaller ones seem to do better. Turf is a great solution if you want an instant lawn. You do still have to prepare the ground, but it is ideal for situations where you can't keep off a lawn for the 2 or 3 weeks you need with seeds. We used a little turf down the bottom end of our garden, where we removed an existing bed, and to replace some rather ugly stepping stones. Due to the bottom of the garden receiving virtually no sunlight, we knew nothing would easily grow there, so have replaced it with a smaller raised bed filled with the Polar Ice Gravel. If you are looking to create a focal point in your garden, you have a lot of choice. Monoliths, water features or boulders can help break up your space and add interest to your design. You could create a unique bench or wall using gabions. You can also encourage wildlife into your garden with the use of bird baths, bird feeders or bug hotels. Alternatively, you may plan to create a play area for your children and have that as the focus. We had plans for a trampoline for our 3-year-old. However, we have realised we don't really have the space, so she will have to make do with the one at her granddad's house. Outside lights are a great way to ensure your flower bed or focal points are lit beautifully at night. There are a huge range of lighting styles and colours available, so you should find the perfect design for your garden. We chose solar-powered LED disc lights, as we wanted something fairly subtle, and we've actually only very recently gotten around to installing them. However, they have completely transformed our garden in the evening, and we would always recommend using lighting in your outside space. So once you have the plan for your garden and have sourced all the materials, then it is time to bring your design to life. You may want to do everything yourself or hire contractors. Either way, check that there are no restrictions on altering your garden. If you have the space, we would suggest ensuring all the main materials are on site and ready for the start of your project, especially if you are using contractors, as the last thing you want is people on site with nothing to do. However, if you don't have storage room, we would always recommend ordering materials to arrive the day before they are required, in case of any delivery delays. We should also note that any work that involves moving or installing gas, electricity or water pipes must be carried out by a professional. The main thing is to try and enjoy your garden makeover. It will seem like hard work at times, but hopefully the pride that you feel in completion will make all the hard work worthwhile, and at the end of the day, you'll have your dream garden. Or at least a garden that makes the most of your space and is better than your old garden. Thank you for watching our How to Makeover a Garden video. We hope you found it useful, and please subscribe for more videos.